Hello friends, welcome to the series of design of machine element lecture. This is fourth lecture in the series. In previous lecture we discussed about what is exactly machine design, types of machine design. In next lecture we discuss about different type of stresses and formulation of different type of stresses. And in this video we are going to take some simple practical based example related to the stresses. After watching this video, student will able to understand or they should able to identify the type of stresses produced in the given problem, and second, they will able to apply formulas and they can able to calculate the things. So let's start with the first problem. This is first problem. A cast iron link is shown in the figure, means a cast iron link is there, which is shown in the figure, means diagram will be there. It is required to transmit a steady tensile load. Load is steady tensile, means here load is given, of magnitude 45 kN, and find the stresses induced in the link at section AA and at section BB. Means we have to find out the stresses at section AA and at section BB. Let's see actual diagram. See friends, this diagram will be provided to you in the paper. Diagram will be provided to you. You have to just observe diagram carefully. Here load will be given. Cross section is also given with dimensions. Here is again one cross section. We have to find out stresses at section AA. Means this is the section A, this is the section B, and we have to find out stresses at section A and stresses at section B. These dimensions are provided to you. Let's see. A designer should able to, or student should able to imagine the 3D diagram of that particular object, and then he can able to solve that particular problem in a practical way. Let's see, this is the 3D or actual view of the link. Here is the link, means load is going to apply. This is 3D diagram, this is 2D diagram, and we have to find out stresses at section A. Let's see, this is the section A, means in this section we have to find out the stresses, means stress will be there at the section A. Let's see, as load is moving in the outward direction through the axis, means type of stresses produced is known as tensile stress. So let's see stresses induced at section A. This is the cross section of section A, and as we know, any type of stress, means tensile stress is there at section A, means sigma T1 will be equal to load per unit area. P is given, P is equal to 45 kN, means P is given, P is equal to 45 into 10 to the power 3 Newton. This is the value of load, P. So sigma T1 is equal to force per unit area. P will be equal to 45 into 10 to the power 3 divided by area. Let's see area. Area, this is the rectangular cross section. This is the width, means 20 by 45. 20 multiplied by 45. This is the area of failure or area of cross section. And after calculating this, with the help of calculator, you can calculate 45 multiplied by 10 to the power 3 divided by area. This will be equal to 50 Newton per mm square. Means sigma T1 will be equal to 50 Newton per mm square. That is 50 MPa. This is the answer of stresses induced. This is the stresses induced at section AA. Now let's move towards stresses at section B. This is the section B, and we have to find out at section B, stresses at section B. Again, due to this load, tensile stress will going to develop over here, and this will result into failure of this component like this. Means, this is the affected area or tensile area here, and we have to find out area. Suppose this is equal to 20, this will be equal to 75, and this is equal to 40. So to find out area, as this is a rectangular one, to find out area will be equal to 20 multiplied by 75. Here is not any cutting, so 75 minus 40, so this will be equal to, area will be equal to 700 mm square. So area at this section will be 700 mm square. So let's see stresses. Again, tensile stress will going to develop over here. So sigma T will be equal to, or sigma T2 will be equal to force per unit area at section B. Area at section B. So P will be equal to 45 into 10 to the power 3 divided by area 700. It will be equal to 64.28 Newton per mm square. So this is the stresses at section B. So let's see, we have to find out stresses at section A and section B, and answer is stresses at section B will be equal to 64.28, and initially we find out stresses at section A, and stresses at section A will be equal to sigma T is equal to 50 Newton per mm square. So this is the answer that we have find out with the help of this form. Okay, let's move towards the second problem, that is calculate the force required to punch a circular blank of 60 mm diameter in a plate of 5 mm thickness. The ultimate shear stress of the plate or for the material is 350 Newton per mm square. So this is the second problem, and this problem is related to punch and punching operation. Let's see, this is the punching operation. This is a punch. With the help of punch, a hole is going to create and blank is going to produce. Means punching operation is there. This is a punch having diameter D. This is the punching force P. Here is the blank. And blank having diameter D, it will be equal to diameter of the punch. So, and T is equal to thickness of the plate. So let's see given data in the problem and what exactly they want to find out. First, diameter of the blank, it will be equal to diameter of punch, and it will be equal to 60 mm. Second given data is thickness of the plate, that is 5 mm. So here I have shown thickness is equal to 5 mm, and this thickness will be equal to thickness of the blank. Second, ultimate shear stress, or third, ultimate shear stress is given, that is equal to 350 Newton per mm square. So these are the things given, and we have to find out first force required to punch the hole, that is P. It is unknown one. And second, after punching or during the punching operation, compressive stress will going to develop inside the punch, that we have to find out. Means first we have to find out punching force, and second we have to find out compressive stress develop inside the punch. So let's see, first stresses in the punch, stresses in the plate during the punching operation. Circumferential shear stress will going to produce in a plate. So after circumferential shear stress, cutting action will be there, and we get this blank having thickness T and diameter D. This is the cutting of the blank. Let's see, circumferential shear stress, or any type of stress, in yesterday's lecture we discussed it, any type of stress is equal to force per unit area. So circumferential shear stress is equal to force per unit area. Area of cutting is this. So P divided by circumferential, means circumference is pi D multiplied by T, pi D into T. As ultimate shear stress is given, that is 350 P divided by pi 60, diameter is 60 and T is equal to 5 mm. Put all values and we get, after calculation, we get punching force will be equal to 329.91 kilonewton. This is in the kilonewton. You can convert it into newton also by multiplying it 1000. So now we have value of punching force. So let's move towards second stress. Means during this punching operation, as punch is going to compress and compressive stress will going to develop inside the punch. So stresses in the punch will be equal to compressive stress, that is force per unit area. And this area is nothing but a area of the punch, cross-sectional area of the punch. This is the cross-sectional area of the punch. This is the cross-sectional area of the punch. It is circular one. So P divided by pi by 4 into D square. So to find out crushing stress or compressive stress inside the punch, it will be equal to force. Value of force, as we know, this is the value of force divided by area, pi by 4 into D square. D is 60. So 60 square, and after doing the calculation, we can find out value of compressive stress, that is equal to 0.116 kilonewton per mm square. This is again in kilonewton per mm square. So in this example, we clear the concept of first circumferential shear stress and second compressive stress. And in first problem we clear the concept of tensile stress and problem related to tensile stress. So this is for stresses. In upcoming video we are going to take more problem related to stresses. Thanks for watching this video carefully.